Good evening, friends. There are negotiations going on in the 27 countries block of Europe. It is the European Union prolonged negotiations. And the issue is on the recovery funds, economic recovery fund worth $2.06 trillion. Now, you may say, why are we discussing this? Because negotiations always happens between the countries within the same block, and especially when huge amount of money is concerned. But these are not normal negotiations. They are prolonged, and not only prolonged, but heated exchange of words between the heads of states have taken place. You may again tell me that these things also happen between the countries when the matter of economy is there. But right now, when the Cold War has begun, this is the worst time to show lack of unity within a liberal bloc. If there is no resolution, they don't reach to some consensus, and if the talks fail, definitely it will have very negative message for the financial markets across the globe, especially in the Europe. But even the prolongment and the heated exchange of words between the leadership of the Union is a positive message for Beijing. And why I am saying this? Because Beijing is already working on a 1+17+1 platform. 17 is for 17 countries of Europe and 1 is China. And this is a platform they made for economic purposes. And if you dissect the geopolitical conditions, the economic conditions, the economic and political conditions of these 17 countries, you will come to know that this is not just a platform for economic works. It is a platform created by Beijing for the purpose of divide and rule the Europe. Now, before we go further, I must tell you which countries constitute this 17+1 platform. The countries are Albania, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Bulgaria, Croatia, Czech Republic, Estonia, Greece, Hungary, Latvia, Lithuania, North Macedonia, Montenegro, Poland, Romania, Serbia, Slovakia, and Slovenia. These constitute the 17+1 is China. So 17+1 platform is made. Now, interestingly, if you go into detail, out of these 17 countries, 10 countries are the member states of European Union. So 10 are the countries out of 27 countries which constitute the EU, the European Union. And already 3 other countries, that is Montenegro, North Macedonia and Serbia, are in the queue for gaining their membership of the Union. And one country of European Union, big state of European Union and important state of European Union, that is Italy, which is not the part of 17+1 platform created by Beijing, is already heartbroken with the European Union because of the way they conducted themselves when Italy was worst hit with coronavirus and it was struggling. They never came to rescue. So this is sending a positive message to the leadership in Beijing that they must go ahead on this 17 plus 1 platform, work diplomatically, financially more upon that, so that they can divide and rule the young. And not to forget that they want to divide the Europe, especially that part of Europe which is in the alliance with NATO, between the prosperous north of European Union and poorer south of European Union for their own sake. Now, right now, the negotiations and the rifts which are between the member states of the European Union are for the grants, for the amount of grant. And Netherlands, which is one of the big players, especially financially, it contributes huge amount to the European Union's kitty, the common pool. It is leading countries which want to limit these grants. And opposing to Netherlands are countries like France, Germany, which are bigger players, and countries of Southern Europe, which are hard hit by the coronavirus, and they want to keep it up till the mark of 500 billion euros. So the whole issue is regarding the grants, but the kind of heated exchanges which took place between the leadership, and most notably between the leadership of Netherlands and Italian Prime Minister. Italian Prime Minister, what he told to Mark Rutte, the Dutch Prime Minister, he told, "You might be a hero in your homeland for a few days, but after a few weeks you will be held responsible before all European citizens for blocking an adequate response." So this type of undiplomatic language and clash of word coming on the platform of European Union is not good for a liberal world order. This is working in favor of China, the world order they want to create. So this is the high time when Mr. Donald Trump and Trump administration must use the American hegemony in the European Union and must come on the driving seat, because the European Union drivers, as per me, are driving the Union on the suicidal path. So America must take a U-turn. It must take the leadership. It must take the driving platform, the driving seat, and use its hegemony so that China doesn't divide and rule the European Union and one of the big players of the liberal world order, which we also want.